There we go. Okay.
All right. So, yeah, since we're recording, let's start right from the top. So today's day is May 4th, 2017. We're at the RCMP headquarters in Fredericton.
Yeah.
My name is Sergeant Mark Budvine. This is my identification.
Yeah.
We've never, we did meet before, but probably don't remember.
No, I don't, of course.
We met downtown a couple of times at the market. I wasn't working then.
Oh, did we talk?
Yeah, because you're always downtown, right? So, yeah.
Did I?
Because you're always downtown, right?
Yeah, are we talking at the market?
Yeah,
okay,
yeah.
Sorry.
I came up in Port Elgin too, so.
Port Elgin?
You're from Merriman Cook,
right? Cook,
yeah. So.
Yeah.
So, yeah, but I don't expect you to remember me from there.
too many.
Well, yeah.
It's like the, I know, okay. It's like, okay, since we're talking about it, it's just like, what was one of the cops' name? Courier, the Edmonton police.
Couturier, yeah.
Couturier.
Yeah.
And he told me, he says, don't you remember me? I was at your house for 300. And you know what? I was looking just there, but I don't remember him. So I don't remember really faces.
Yeah.
Getting old.
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
Yeah, you do see a lot of people, right?
So, oh.
So right now, time's around 9:30 and 9:35 now. So you're accompanied by Liz?
Liz, just Liz.
Liz, okay. So your support friend kind of thing?
Yeah.
So the reason why I wanted to talk to you today is I'm investigating on behalf of the Fredericton Police Force a complaint that you made in December 2016 in regards to allegations of assault for November 8th, 2016.
Yeah.
the reason why it came to me, just to give you some background, or to us really, is that after the Bernard Richard report, basically to Fredericton Police, if you make a complaint to them, they'll reach out to the other police forces now and they won't handle it themselves.
Should have been outside, yeah.
Exactly. So it was made pretty clear at the end of that report there, it was one of the recommendations that some kind of agreement would be set up between the police forces in New Brunswick to have that happen in the future. So they reached out to us and was assigned to me in March. So since then I've been reviewing a lot of stuff. I'm near the end, actually, and but I wanted to cover off with you your statement there. And just by covering off, what I mean is just a follow-up question. That's it.
Yeah. Right?
So basically, just for the recording too, you asked me to address you in English before, right? So,
yeah.
And you're here on your own free will. You don't have to be here if you don't want
no.
right? So the door's right there if you want to, but
if I was
really
charged, if I was charged with murder or something like that, but okay, yeah, see you later. Yeah.
Exactly, right?
Exactly.
So. Yeah, so that's what we're here for today. So what I was explaining to you before we started the recording there was a process as to the two complaints, right? One's the New Brunswick Police Commission that's going to look at a lot of stuff as to why you were investigated and all of that stuff. And that's for the file that was concluded recently, April, a month ago now. I'm not looking at that, right? I just want to make that clear. What I'm investigating is the events of November 8th. Now, yes, I do have to go back to understand why they did what they did, if there is an explanation or not. And so that's what I'm focusing on is specifically that day, November 8th.
Yeah.
So you understand that?
Yeah.
Do you have any questions so far?
No.
So I don't think we're going to be here long, but yeah, like anything you think that would be good for me to know, sure, go ahead. But you know, you might have some questions that I can't really answer because they're going to be investigated by the commission afterwards, right?
Yeah.
But I'll do my best for you, for sure.
No question. That's why I'm here. The video speaks for itself. So.
Yeah. All right. I want to drop this on your camera, Charles.
Oh, no, of course not.
Sure.
A mistake. Whoops.
That wouldn't be good.
That was easy.
Whoops.
You have a middle name, Charles?
Joseph.
See, you just got back on the coffee?
Oh, yeah, you've been following that.
No, I don't go on your blog a whole lot there, but the last day I have, because I just wanted to see the best way to reach you there. And I saw you stopped, you said for a month?
Month.
I stopped for 3 years because it was basically punching a hole in my stomach there, so I didn't have a choice. I really like coffee, especially on night shifts.
It
kept me going, but
why did you start again?
You know what happened?
Like you.
No. What happened is, I mean, I stopped, right? The first 3 weeks were just complete hell.
Oh, yeah.
Complete hell. I was cranky, and I knew it was all in my head, right? But you do your best.
You're lucky I had coffee. I'll really be cranky. Okay, go ahead.
Yeah. So what, and I actually have a lot of kids at home, right? But I blasted through that. I really toughed it out for 3 years. I was drinking tea instead. And then what happened when Christmas season, my wife came back with a jug of, how do you call it? Eggnog. Right? So basically had a glass of eggnog. So I'll just put a little bit of coffee in there. Just right. So I put a little bit. And sure enough, after 2 weeks, it was back to full coffee and a little bit of eggnog. And
she gave me again. She gave me milk. She doesn't want me to have cream, so terrible.
How was your month though without coffee?
Good, good. Headache that first grows from the grow chili, you said moving.
Yeah.
No fool. I have ADHD, usually I would run around.
I think it's the sugar. It's the sugar.
Yeah.
I used to take sugar, and then addicted. Mm. It's like, where in the heck? No sugar.
Yeah, right.
You do. You can get addicted to the sugar.
Mm. I find it amazing. Our month ago, we were big lineup for driving. Big lineup for coffee. We do two drive-through at Tim Horton, our month.
Yeah.
McDonald's, nothing.
Nobody.
Nobody. I found that amazing. I thought, you know.
It's always like that.
I love a McDonald's coffee.
Yeah, it is good.
I love McDonald's.
So we're giving some advertisement for coffee here, McDonald's and Tim Hortons.
Debate.
So it's audio recorded. I'm just going to take a couple of notes down, but I'm not going to write down word for word like Fredrik and Peter did, because we'll be here all day.
Yes.
All right, so can you confirm for me that this was your statement that day, that you wrote that?
To whom it may concern, November 8th, not around.
Because I don't know your handwriting, so I just want to make sure that was you.
I was confronted by two individuals wearing suits. One quickly passed his pledge, and the other stood behind me. I didn't know what was going on, so I quickly went for my camera. You can email me at omazon. I kind of have a hard time reading my own handwriting, omazon@yahoo.com.
That's why I emailed you at that address last night.
Yeah, that's where you got it. And I will send you the video. Situation turned ugly once one of them grabbed me and told me I was under arrest. I demanded the presence of a uniformed police officer, which was the RCMP, but they refused. They grabbed me and I backed off in the middle of the street. I could have been hit by a car. I was hurt, soldier, and I haven't been the same since. That's my little bit paranoid. One of the officers, Andre Madaw, told me that he was the chief of the Edmonton Police Force. He later apologized at the station. Email me for video if you wish. I was assaulted by two strangers who lied to me in presentation introducing themselves. Andre Madaw wasn't the chief of police. Situation could have turned very ugly, very fast. I want a police force probably from outside of the province to investigate these two officers. Their names are Deputy Chief Andre Madaw and Sergeant Arjan Couturier, Charles Leblanc.
No, in regards to outside the province, sir, I can't, you know, I have no idea why it came to me. I'm assuming that based on that memorandum of understanding that they signed together, they have to keep it within.
I was just concerned because Bobby Simmons was one of them mentioned, mm-hmm. and she's married to an RCMP officer. Mm-hmm. So I thought it would be a conflict. So. You know,
I don't know Bobby, so
yeah, I thought so. That's why I said just I like to have it as independent as possible.
I understand that, yeah. But it did come to me. It's not like I asked for it. I want you to understand so as to why it stayed in New Brunswick instead of going out. Yeah. That's something that would have to be addressed within the chiefs, right?
Yeah.
So I don't know, or with the police commission maybe.
Yeah,
right.
I don't know.
Okay, so based on what's here. Everything's still good?
Yeah.
Anything change? That you want to change based on what you read?
I do not believe, no.
Then there was some questions and some answers that were provided between you and Fredericton Police Force there. So there's two more pages.
Question. Where did these allegations of assault take place? Answer. Corner of St. John and Cake Street, right behind the legislator around 1 p.m. Question. Were they any witness? No, but some guy wrote, what's this? Some guy took a video, yeah.
Yeah.
Social, social. Oh God, I thought my handwriting was bad.
I can read it for you.
Maybe if somebody give me a link, I can send this video to an investigator. I don't know who took the video. Question: describe the nature of the assault. Grab me by the arm, and the other grab me by the shoulder. They slam against the building, Century Place. I screamed and drew attention as they stopped. Prior to the assault, altercation. Did those people that arrested you and identify themselves? Mr. Andre, shove a badge right quick. I hear Police Chief Edmiston. I don't know what it says there. What says there?
That other guy stood behind me.
Yeah. I didn't know who these people were. They said they were, for a drive. Going for a drive. After the arrest, were you charged of an offense? Nope. They interviewed me for half an hour.
Okay. So that stands. That's so good.
Yeah.
Okay. So a couple of things. I based myself on this one too. I thought this post that you have here, back from Holland, it doesn't print well, right? From November 26, 2016. Basically, you start by, this is a copy of the following message sent to the NB Police Commission, right? So that's your post that goes into detail as to what happened that day, right? So you actually provide more detail here than what's in here, I found. But I just wanted to...
happened is I just took the video, I took the statement from the video, word by word.
Yeah.
And just made sure that...
Exactly. So you went through the video and then...
One by one, you
built your statement.
Word by word,
and that's fine, yeah. Yeah, it's your video anyway, so it's kind of like your notes, really.
Yeah.
And then you, you're asking then the NB Police Commission to answer a lot of questions there, basically. So I just want to confirm that this is from you, basically, and I can sort of add that to your statement initially,
yeah.
Right?
I wonder if after you finish all this, you keep on reading my blog, you'll say, my God, there's a lot of bullshit here. Like I always tell people, I'm the biggest blood strangers. I said, you know what a blogger is? I said, yes. I said, I'm the biggest blogger in New Brunswick, and I'm also the biggest bullshitter you ever met. They go hand in hand. You know what I mean? Huh? I said, well, that's good. Anybody else? And that's Bobby Sennett, that's the one that I'm talking about. That's her there. Seba?
Alright, so. Thank you very much. So based on what's here, like I only have a couple of questions here, and I got video from a lot of sources, actually. I've got yours, I've got the unknown witness there that showed up on his bike. I've been...
Did you talk to him?
I spent a couple of weeks trying to find him, so that's why I wanted to ask you if you have any idea who that person is. You
don't know? I only know him by first name.
First name?
Tony.
Is he still around?
Oh, yeah. Well, it just happened.
Well, because I saw his Live Leak page where he posted it at first, right? So I thought Tony, so I've been trying. I looked up, you know, tattoo shops, you name it, right? I've been downtown, right? And
can't find him.
Well,
sorry,
go ahead.
You could give me your card.
Yeah.
And if I see him, I'll tell him to contact you.
Yeah, sure. I'm not sure I need it, though, because, I mean, there's so much video footage. Like, he gets there sort of part way, and he leaves before it's done, right? So I do have his part there, and I've got footage from the buildings around, right? So I've got lots of sources of video.
Oh, yeah,
you know what I mean?
That's right, because security, that's another thing. I don't know how much, I don't know the story, but there's a lot of cameras in New Brunswick. Legislator, they got cameras all over the place.
That's right. So
you've seen those.
So I have that, right?
Good.
So I've got all of that, but
I've never seen that.
Yeah, but I just don't know. Well, there's not much more than what you've... It's a different vantage point, and it's so far away that it's not really zoomed in, so it's kind of, you know what I mean?
You see them arriving.
I don't have that part. So that's why I want to talk to you. There are two things, right? There was their arrival and...
Hold it. 1 second. Sorry. There's about 5 cameras around.
Mm.
No cameras film them.
I don't have that. Because the one spot that could have caught that would be the legislature, right?
Yes.
And in the back, there's a tree there, and it covers that. I don't know. Like, I wasn't impressed when I heard that. Because we don't see what's on
there. There's a murder there, and we missed that. The tree's in the way.
Exactly.
How about the camera that's up ahead, that's across the street?
Yeah, it wasn't there either.
What about the camera that's in the Century Place by the river?
No, I've got those, right? And you don't see that. So when it starts, basically, from what I have for the footage there, they're already talking to you, right? So I just want to know where they came from, if you remember. Or like that first minute, you know how you start your statement there, basically, that you were around, you were at the...
Yeah, corner.
No, you were confronted there.
Yeah.
But basically, you were at the corner there. And
I was
then,
in the corner.
And then when they approach you, you take your camera out. But in that first minute before, I just need to know what happened there, because I don't...
I got no problem with that.
Mm.
I was at the corner of St. John and King.
Mm-hmm.
You've been there, you see?
Yep. Oh, yeah.
Okay. So I'm being sarcastic. So anyway, so I just, you gotta go to the scene of the crime. I was standing there waiting for what I usually do. As you've seen, I'm a blogger,
mm-hmm.
and I chase the politician, ask questions. So I waited for a minister to come out the door. So they run across the street.
Yeah.
And you can ask questions on my concern issue of the day.
You hang around the back door or the front door?
No, the corner. Right
oh,
there.
Yeah, yeah.
The Chancery Place is there,
yeah.
The departmental building.
Yeah.
They come out of there. They used to come from the Centennial Building.
Yeah.
But they come out there, and then that's who I wait for. So next thing you know, I see two guys are coming toward me.
Mm.
My dog was... I was there, and then I hear, Monsieur Leblanc. My look, there's two guys coming. One guy came and said, mention, I hear the word Edmiston, Chef Edmiston. That's all I hear, far away. And come across one of this, shut fast. And then I just look at it maybe for half a second. And then there's a guy, Couturier's name, came behind me.
Mm.
So then I went, what's going on? And then about maybe, then when they said something about police, but come with us for a conduit.
That's when you pulled out your camera. Okay.
That's where I put the camera on. And I didn't know what was going on. Two strangers in clothes.
Understandable.
Come with us for a drive.
Yeah.
At the police station.
Mm.
I mean, I don't know if I'm supposed to stick my tongue out like a dog and say, really? We're going to go for a drive?
Mm.
So, that's why I put the camera on and the rest.
Okay, so basically there was only like before your footage started, maybe a minute worth of
No, no.
That's all.
15, okay. Maybe 15, 20 seconds.
Okay.
Because usually I always carry that with me and I always got that camera on video.
Mm.
If something like this happens, because I'm a little bit paranoid with the battle with the Fenton police, you don't know when they're going to come, or you have, I call it my weapon, but I call it this. It's
I know
my
what
camera,
you mean. Yeah. I know what you mean. Yeah.
Evidence.
Yeah.
So what happens? So 15, 20 seconds, the most.
Yeah.
And then when they mention, then that's where I said, well, that's where I put my camera. Then the video speaks for itself.
Yeah. All right. That's pretty much it. Just wanted to know if you know who the unknown witness is in that first minute or so. And
like I said, he wouldn't be, I don't know how much help he could be.
I mean, aside from saying, I shot that video, which really, you know, we've got so much other footage, it's not that crucial, right? As long as he could be identified if we really needed it down the road. But,
give me your card. I'll next time I see him, I'll contact him. Can he call you?
Oh yeah. Yeah,
I'll call you.
Because
I admire him, what he did, and it's not too many. There were a lot of citizens around.
It's not my cards.
I know there was the only reporter. There was a reporter there, Nick Moore. He was filming.
Yeah.
But he did say arrive after everybody here. The commotions. The only reason I was screaming is just to attract attention. I didn't know who these two people were.
Yeah. Okay.
there would have been a uniformed person around, maybe it would have been different.
What's the last name of Henri, the, I almost forgot.
The police?
No, not the police officer, the other one from the legislature, because I remember in the video you call out to him, you say...
Henri Ouellette, yeah. He works for public safety.
And, first minute. Okay, so that's all I wanted to ask you, Charles. Do you have any questions for me, or like in regards to the process as to where this goes once I'm done? My job is to put all the facts together, do up a report on that, and then I'll give it to the Crown for the Crown to go through it. Crown prosecutor that was assigned is out in Moncton there, so he's never dealt with you before. All the Fredericton ones, I guess they've got complaints against them, so they didn't want to. So anyway, we do have one down in Moncton. He's going to go through it for transparency's sake, right? Because really, I don't know these two guys in Edmonton there, but I am a police officer and so are they, so there needs to be some transparency there.
That's all I want. By the facts.
Yeah. So there's no question that physical contact was made. I mean, there's so much footage there. The question is, were they in the execution of their duties, right? That's a big determination there as to whether or not they...
Do they have jurisdiction to come here?
Yes.
They could do that.
Yeah. If you're a peace officer, in Edmonton PD...
You're sworn to the municipality of your duties. That means you're also sworn to the province?
Within that province, right? Because say if I'm off duty there and I just happen to be downtown in Fredericton and I see something happening, even though I'm off duty, even though I'm not a Fredericton City police officer, I still have to do something to help out, right? And that's...
But who from here, somebody from here had to have called them and told them about everything?
Oh yeah, they made a complaint.
That'll come up from the police commission when they get back to you in regards to that. What I think happened there is after the Bernard Richard report, which is what happened in this case and us getting this, Fredericton PD, after those members complained, they probably looked around to see who can investigate this, and Edmonton probably put their hands up. That's what I can see could have happened there, but the police commission can probably answer it.
They charged me with an assault charge, which I was found not guilty after, which should have never seen the light of day.
Edmonton?
This was in Miramichi police. And what
happened? A while back.
Okay. So this idiotic so-called poet, anyway, come after me. I protected myself, which is in, you know. And I was found not guilty, no problem. Mm-hmm. But when they served me, when they came in and showed me the documents to show them in court, there was a cop, plain clothes, from Miramichi, and there was a uniformed police officer, Tim Sowers, beside him. Mm. Shouldn't the same thing happen here?
Well, it's their call, right, if they want to do it or not. Like, I've approached people in plain clothes, but ideally, yeah. But that's their, you know, there's no policy in place that says you need to be in uniform to arrest somebody. It's not there, but, you know... It's basically call the call. So that's kind of outside of what I'm doing there. Yeah. But the police commission can certainly look at that as to say, okay, you had this strategy in place. Was it the right strategy? And is it in line with your internal policies at Edmonton PD? You know what I mean?
Well, just like Michel Viano in Batters. I know we're going a different route here. Like Michel Viano, they were shot by the Batters police. And there was no uniform around from what we hear.
Yeah.
So if there was a uniform around. And what I'm saying is when they come out, there should be uniform that people would know.
Yeah.
But the commission will decide that.
Like, I mean, I can tell you what I do. If I'm doing a search warrant somewhere, we have people in uniform with us, with a marked police car, so that people know. Right?
This wasn't a search warrant.
That's what we do.
Yeah.
But, you know, it's not, you know, the RCMP doesn't decide what all the other police forces do, right? Let's put it that way.
Did you talk to the other cops from Edmonton?
That's right at the end.
So you don't know where the car was parked when they approach?
Not yet. I'm assuming it's at the intersection somewhere. Did you see the car? No, you didn't?
No, I don't know.
Really, is it... I can't see that it was that far, right? If their intent was to arrest you and take you somewhere, they can't be parked 5 blocks away.
No, I know.
So, yeah.
Okay, you're done? I'm done?
Unless you have any other questions for me, that's it. Okay, so let's set the recording. It's 10 o'clock now.
What time you going? Quebec time? I'm going, but it's 9:57.
I'm not from Quebec.
I had to blow it. I know you're not from Quebec, you're Canadian. We're doing so good. I had to blow it right at the end.
It's 10 o'clock.
It's 9:57. 9:58.
I wouldn't say I'm Acadian, though.